So Jerry becoming a hurricane as of the 11 a.m. advisory. There it is right there, getting closer and closer to the Caribbean, but it is going to make that critical turn towards the north. There's also Umberto moving over into the northern Atlantic. There are several other areas for potential of development, and then there is the remnants of Imelda that is still bringing some heavy downpours across portions of far southeastern Texas and southwestern Louisiana. Look at this. These thunderstorms are certainly severe. So the threat for tornadoes still exists between Houston and Lake Charles, along with the flooding and flash flooding. That definitely remains a major threat. Now on to Hurricane Jerry. With maximum sustained winds of 75 miles per hour, it is moving swiftly at a good speed. This is good. At 16 miles per hour west northwest. It is located roughly 490 miles east of the Leeward Islands. Now look at the forecast cone. That cone keeps it just north and east of the Leeward Islands and north of Puerto Rico as it makes that turn more towards the north through the weekend and early next week. But then it starts to make a turn towards the northeast direction, and once again Bermuda is now under this forecast cone, and it could potentially still be a Category 1 hurricane. Now, Umberto is moving farther away from Bermuda, but still some nasty conditions there. Jerry is expected to move into a weakness between two highs, and these models are in clear agreement of that critical turn towards the north. Back here at home, we are dealing with some windy conditions, plus we're watching other areas out there in the Atlantic that have the potential for formation.